all these questions, which they are raising and what they are raising now, that have been replied in the recently concluded parliament session.
हमसे तो किसी ने बात नहीं की है, क्योंकि पश्चिम बंगाल में कोविड खत्म हो गया, बिहार का कोविड खत्म हो गया, देश का कोविड खत्म हो गया।
नॉन कॉलिंग ऑफ द विंटर सेशन ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट इज अ कोल्ड ब्लडेड मर्डर ऑफ द डेमोक्रेसी।
You're watching News Epicenter with me, Maria Shakil. A bitter war has erupted between the centre and the opposition over the scrapping of the winter session of Parliament. Delhi is one of the worst affected cities in the country, and the centre's case is that winter is critical for COVID management and they want to avoid an outbreak in the temple of democracy. Parliamentary Affairs Minister Prahlad Joshi has also said that he consulted opposition leaders before a decision was taken to scrap the winter session. The centre says that it is ready to hold the next session early and is not shying away from tough questions. The opposition, namely the Congress, has accused the centre of lying, saying their leaders were not consulted, adding that the centre wants to avoid a debate on the farm bills as the deadlock continues with farmer groups. But beyond the politics, the question remains, why should Parliament be in lockdown when the rest of the country is unlocking? All of us have been working since the pandemic hit the country, then why should our elected lawmakers step back? Malls, markets, restaurants, transport networks, businesses and offices have been running, implementing COVID protocols to avoid a spread of the virus. Then why can't Parliament? The monsoon session was held during the peak of the pandemic. Several state legislatures are running. Election campaigns have been on while legislatures around the world, including the centre, is holding meetings following COVID rules. Going virtual as the new normal, then why can't the winter session be held as we learn to live with the pandemic? Joining us on the top of the show is Minister of State for Parliamentary Affairs, Arjun Ram Meghwal. Meghwal ji, thank you so much for your time. जब चुनाव हो सकते हैं, अभी असेंबली का चुनाव हुआ है बिहार में, इलेक्शन रैलीज निकल रही हैं, ऑपोजिशन का कहना है मॉल्स, स्कूल सब खुल गए हैं, हिंदुस्तान अब अनलॉक 5 फेज में है, तो पार्लियामेंट क्यों नहीं चल सकता?
चर्चा में देखिए, मैं आपको ये बताना चाहता हूँ मारिया जी, कि हमारा जो सत्र था मानसून सत्र, मानसून सेशन, वो हमने लंबी अवधि का डिजाइन किया था, लेकिन अपोजिशन से सलाह की तब अपोजिशन ने कहा इसको जल्दी खत्म करिए, कोविड फैल रहा है। ऑफ द रिकॉर्ड बात करते समय उन्होंने ऐसा ही कहा, और उसके बाद जब ये हमारा विंटर सेशन आने लगा तब भी हम चर्चा कर रहे थे लगातार, मैं, प्रहलाद जोशी जी हमारे संसदीय कार्य मंत्री, मुरलीधरन जी, अभी केवड़िया गुजरात में सारे पीठासीन अधिकारियों का सम्मेलन था, उसमें अधीर रंजन चौधरी जी खुद वहां उपस्थित थे गुजरात में। हमने उनसे बात की तो उन्होंने कहा यार अब मत बुलाइए। टीएमसी के लोगों से बात की, वो बोला हम तो कमेटी मीटिंग अटेंड नहीं करते हैं, आप सेशन अभी मत बुलाइए। हमने बीजेटी से बात की, उन्होंने कहा मत बुलाइए। डीएमके से बात की, मत बुलाइए। तो फिर अपोजिशन जब चाह ही नहीं रहा था तो फिर सत्र कैसे बुलाएं हम, बताइए आप।
लेकिन कांग्रेस का कहना है कि बिना कंसल्ट किए गए उनको ये फैसला लिया है, आपने उनसे बातचीत नहीं की और ये सेशन नहीं बुलाया।
नहीं 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 नहीं, हुआ है, बोले अपोजिशन, मैं खुद साथ था, हमारे प्रहलाद जोशी ने सबको फोन किया, मैंने भी दो तीन लोगों से बात की, ये अधीर रंजन चौधरी जी से तो बात हुई, तब मैं और प्रहलाद जोशी दोनों थे वहीं पे केवड़िया में, गुजरात में पीठासीन अधिकारियों के सम्मेलन में, फिर उन्होंने किसके कहने से चिट्ठी लिख दी, फिर भी हमने टेलीफोन पे बात की।
तो फिर ये जो डॉक्टर शशि थरूर जो कांग्रेस के एमपी हैं, उन्होंने जो प्रपोजल दिया है वर्चुअल पार्लियामेंट का, वो क्यों नहीं हो सकता?
शशि थरूर जी नेता नहीं है लोकसभा में, लोकसभा में नेता अधीर रंजन चौधरी जी, फ्लोर लीडर। हमने फ्लोर लीडर से बात की है, जैसे सुधीर बंदोपाध्याय से बात की टीएमसी में, इधर अधीर रंजन चौधरी से बात की है, इधर पिनाकी मिश्रा जी से बीजू जनता दल से बात की है, इधर डीएमके से टीआर बालू से बात की है।
नहीं, अगर उनके प्रपोजल की बात की जाए कि जब वर्क फ्रॉम होम हो सकता है तो 543 MPs क्यों नहीं कनेक्ट हो सकते हैं, और वर्क जिस तरह से उसी तरह से पार्लियामेंट फ्रॉम होम क्यों नहीं हो सकता?
वो एक विषय उन्होंने स्पीकर साहब को लिख के दिया था, वो विषय मारिया जी उन्होंने स्पीकर साहब को लिख के दिया था, तो उसमें कोई रूल्स आड़े आ रहे होंगे, इस वजह से वो उसका डिसीजन नहीं हुआ। इसमें गवर्नमेंट को इसमें डिसीजन नहीं लेना था, गवर्नमेंट को सत्र कब बुलाना इस पे डिसीजन लेना था, तो गवर्नमेंट ने कहा भी कंसल्टेशन कर लो फ्लोर लीडर से, तो हमने फ्लोर लीडर से कंसल्टेशन किया, सब ने ये कहा मत बुलाओ अभी दिल्ली में बहुत कोविड बढ़ रहा है।
ओके, लेकिन ऑपोजिशन ये भी कह रही है कि आप चर्चा नहीं करना चाहते, अभी फार्म लॉस के मुद्दे पर किसान सड़क पर हैं, आप इन गंभीर मुद्दों पर चर्चा से भाग रहे हैं।
नहीं नहीं, ऐसा नहीं है, देखिए एग्रीकल्चर बिलों के बारे में चर्चा जुलाई 90 से हो रही है, चर्चा नहीं होती, डिमांड नहीं होती तो पॉलिटिकल पार्टियों के घोषणा पत्र में ये नहीं आता, हमारे घोषणा पत्र में भी था, कांग्रेस के घोषणा पत्र में भी था, डीएमके के घोषणा पत्र में था, समाजवादी पार्टी के घोषणा पत्र में था, एग्रीकल्चर रिफॉर्म होने चाहिए, इसलिए रिफॉर्म बिल आए।
अगर कोरोना केसेस इसी तरह से रहे तो क्या माना जाए कि आप बजट सेशन भी बुलाने में डिले करेंगे?
नहीं, अभी तो कोरोना के केसेस थोड़े थोड़े कम हो रहे हैं ना मारिया जी, और उस समय की परिस्थितियां देखेंगे, क्या वो परिस्थितियां कैसी रहेगी, उसके बाद अपोजिशन से बात करके ही हम जो बजट सेशन है, वैसे हमारे पार्लियामेंट के जो मंत्री है उन्होंने जो अधीर रंजन चौधरी जी को चिट्ठी लिखी है उसमें उन्होंने कहा बजट सेशन होगा, अभी बजट सेशन 1 फरवरी को बजट हम प्रस्तुत करते हैं, तो आज की परिस्थिति के अनुसार तो बजट सेशन होगा, यही हमने उनको अधीर रंजन चौधरी जी को राइटिंग में भी दिया।
आखिरी सवाल आपसे, डिबेट एंड डिस्कशंस आर एसेंस ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी, दे आर अ मस्ट, इस तरह से अगर पार्लियामेंट फंक्शन नहीं करेगा और चर्चा नहीं होगी तो आपको नहीं लगता कि डेमोक्रेसी और उसके प्रिंसिपल्स को कॉम्प्रोमाइज कर रही है ये सरकार?
नहीं नहीं, पार्लियामेंट तो हमने मानसून सत्र भी इतनी अवधि का बुलाया था ना, आप तो खुद गवाह हैं, बाद में जब केसेस बढ़ने लगे, काफी लोग पॉजिटिव हुए, तो सभी अपोजिशन के लोगों ने कहा, स्पीकर साहब ने मीटिंग बुलाई सबकी और सबने कहा पार्लियामेंट सेशन को जल्दी समाप्त करिए, कंसल्टेशन से ही हुआ ना ये।
All right. Arjun Ram Meghwal, always a pleasure to have you. Thank you so much for joining us. And let me bring in my next newsmaker, Congress Member of Parliament, Dr. Shashi Tharoor. Dr. Tharoor, appreciate your time. Why is the Congress up in arms against the government when the last time around during the monsoon session, the Congress on most occasions did not participate in the legislative agenda and chose to walk out?
Now listen, walkouts and so on are occasioned by specific circumstances, but that's not true about most occasions. In fact, on many occasions we participated. I myself led the discussion on the COVID mismanagement going on in this country at the time. So I can assure you that we are very committed to parliamentary deliberation. But the bigger issue is that the country is in crisis right now. And given the extraordinary number of serious, vital issues facing the nation, first of all, the fact that this COVID situation itself requires a fresh discussion. Second, the farmers' agitation, because that's been provoked specifically by a hasty parliamentary action by the BJP government last time in rushing these three bills through without any discussion with a parliamentary standing committee or with consultation with the stakeholders. Third, the unemployment crisis in the country. We have the worst unemployment ever recorded. And fourth, the rather desperate economic situation with economic growth unplummeted. All of those give us very important, vital issues. If the elected representatives of the people are not discussing them, then what is a parliament for?
Okay, you know, Dr. Tharoor, you have demanded virtual session, saying why the session could not be held virtually, and the idea of parliament from home, and why shouldn't it happen?
Right, so the first thing is that if at all the government is going to argue that last time we held a session, we were forced to cut it short because so many MPs caught COVID, which at that time was certainly a true concern. Then there are two counter arguments. One is, of course, that how is it that a government that openly conducts rallies and conducts campaigns for elections and so on is not willing to have parliamentarians gather? That's one level of the argument. The other argument is, if you really feel there is a risk to the health and safety of parliamentarians and ministers by getting together physically, then why not do it virtually? Mm-hmm. After all, many countries have either done virtual parliaments or have done hybrid parliaments where they can meet and discuss issues with some people sitting in the physical hall and a larger number logging in from home. The point is, the government seems to find one specious reason after another not to be accountable. Today, I think a young man on Twitter called Paritosh Shunya has tweeted a long list of what's happening in all the other G20 countries, Argentina, Australia, Kenya, you got them all, Britain, the US, all of these countries listed, in which he points out that every one of them, the parliaments have not only been meeting, but have actually taken up very important far-reaching issues. The argument being that this is a time of crisis. Parliament is never more needed than at a time of crisis.
Okay. Dr. Tharoor, I had the Minister of State for Parliamentary Affairs on the show just a few minutes ago, and also Parliamentary Affairs Minister Prahlad Joshi has said that he informally contacted floor leaders of various political parties before taking this decision. Do you feel this should be done, virtual parliament for the budget session, in case situation does not improve?
So on the first part of the question, the two Congress party parliamentary leaders in the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha say they were not consulted and would not have agreed. Indeed, Adhir Ranjan Chaudhary, my colleague in the Lok Sabha, actually wrote to the minister asking for a session. And I remember tweeting in support and defense of that request about 3 weeks ago. Secondly, Ghulam Nabi Azad says he got no call at all, and he's a leader in the Rajya Sabha. So when Mr. Joshi claims he had informal consultations, I wonder how these were consulted. But in any case, that's not the point. The point is that the government doesn't need to shelter behind small opposition parties of a handful of people. Its real reason appears to be it doesn't want to answer tough questions. And we've seen this time and time again. This is not a government that enjoys being accountable. The China conflict is one which was never discussed in the Lok Sabha, even though when India went to war with China in 62, Prime Minister Nehru acceded to a request from Mr. Vajpayee to actually have a debate while the war was going on. Now, that's the way in which democracies are supposed to function, not this way.
You know, Dr. Tharoor, if debate is the essence of parliamentary democracy, as you said it rightly, then the opposition has been anything but participative in the last few sessions when the government pushed through key legislative agendas. What is it that the opposition had planned differently in this winter session?
No, we are very, very keen on discussing every issue that comes before the House. I personally have never subscribed to any strategy of disruption or walkout, but those who have actually done this have said that they're doing it only because they were provoked beyond the point of endurance by the government taking completely unreasonable stands on certain issues, particularly in the states. Problem in that particular instance is that it's too easy to turn around and say, why do you want parliament if you're not prepared to debate? And I can understand that objection. I do believe we should use parliament in order to debate and to put our point of view before the nation. But once in a while, when you're there together in parliament and the nation's attention is focused on parliament, it does become an opportunity to protest some atrocities very, very strongly.
Last question to you. The fact is that the farm bills have been discussed in the parliament over the last two decades, including when UPA was in power. Is the demand of seeking winter session to debate the same, that is the farm laws, convenient, I would say, because the parliamentary panel of which the Congress party was part of it had signed off?
Harir, there are people, lakhs of people sitting in protest at the entryways to Delhi, at the borders between Haryana and Delhi, between Rajasthan and Haryana. The country is facing a genuine crisis. Normally, it's when the nation is in crisis that the government should be responding and should first of all be taking Parliament into confidence about its response and should be hearing the points of view of its critics in Parliament. Now we're looking at a situation where these sort of Tughlaqi firmans are issued and there is absolutely no feedback mechanism, which is what has led people to protest on the streets. I think if we can use the institutions of our democracy better, after all, our government has just laid the foundation stone for a new parliament building. Why keep building parliament buildings if you don't actually want to do any meaningful discussion in them, if you don't want to answer questions in them, if you don't want to be accountable to the opposition in them? The point is not the size of your majority, which is what the BJP keeps citing. Nehruji had a far bigger majority, but he was incredibly attentive to the numerically insignificant opposition because he understood that's what democracy is all about. Democracy is not about winning an election every 5 years and doing what you please in between.
Okay.
Democracy is a constant process of engagement, deliberation, discussion, and accountability. The sooner the BJP understands that, the better it'll be for the health of our democracy in India.
All right, Dr. Shashi Tharoor, thank you so much for your time here on News Epicenter. Let me bring in my guests. Sabha Naqvi is a senior journalist, someone who has been tracking Parliament for years. Shantanu Gupta is a political analyst. Shantanu, I'm going to begin with you. Somehow government's arguments of not having a parliament session doesn't cut much ice, I would say. Look at several state legislatures. Bihar, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, all have had their winter session. Why is it difficult to conduct the parliament then?
See, I think we all know, we all living in Delhi. Delhi's cases are rising. Delhi has come as a hotbed for corona because of the kind of population density it has. And we all know the winter in Delhi is tough, and winter plus COVID is a very bad combination, right? So I think this is very apt that government has decided. And as you also told while you were interviewing Dr. Tharoor, that the parliamentary minister, Mr. Joshi, has talked informally to the party heads. And I think this is a very interesting habit of Congress party members, and which we keen in the case of GST also. Inside the GST council, they say something else, they agree to it, and they come out just for the public perception, they say it's a Gabbar Singh tax, right? That happens every time. So I think they agree at close quarters, and they come out just to gain public sympathy and to create confusion. So I think, and as you talk, like we have seen session after session, how Congress have not involved in meaningful debates. If you see this attendance of Rahul Gandhi, one of their tall leaders, if I can call him a tall leader, in whole of 17 Lok Sabha, his attendance itself is 50%. So I don't know how much meaningful debate they anyway do, right? And now at the corona time, when the country is dealing with corona and a lot of MPs have requested for changing the session, I think now they're making it a fuss, right? But yeah, there's a suggestion that can we move it to an online format? The courts are working in online format. I think that will be a welcome suggestion if the technology can be developed quickly till the budget session.
You know, Sabha, the view being presented by the government is that the opposition runs away from debate and stages walkout. That is also a reality. Also, the fact is that previous sessions have seen record passage of legislations and productivity has been at an all-time high. So if anything, the government has displayed its intent in the number of hours both houses have clocked in.
So, Maria, here's the rub. First of all, I'll just very quickly mention, we do know that our chief guest is supposed to be Boris Johnson, the British Prime Minister. That country, which was when he was in hospital, the Britain on which the Westminster model on which our democracy is based, developed a hybrid form of parliament, and they went back to parliament even as the prime minister was in hospital. That is what a genuine democracy does. Now, and we are that. So I found the interview that you did with the minister very interesting, Maria, I must say so, because he is saying that he spoke to all of them and they didn't want to come to parliament.
He spoke to all floor leaders, and they had agreed. They had in fact suggested the government, according to the minister, to not hold the winter session.
Now, so now if they're saying this informally, this is the opportunity of the government to call their bluff and say that we are upholding parliament. We are going to call you, come and attend this session. We'll find a hybrid way of doing it. So something, I think, does not sit right here. And since when did the government become so mindful of the opposition? He's saying in informal discussions, they didn't want to do it. So we have to, I'm saying, you know, sometimes something is in a gray area. Informally, many MPs would have told him that. So I'm fascinated by that, what he said, and he is standing by what he said. But now we have a situation right now when all the parties do want to have a say, which is significant. I mean, democracy is not about brute majorities. It is about diversities of voices. And frankly, the fact that all the most of the developed...
No, but what do you have to say about Rahul Gandhi and his attendance in Parliament?
Rahul Gandhi is an entirely different question, Maria.
Shantanu, in fact, Shantanu Gupta raised it. I did not talk about it, Sabha.
That besides the point, we can all discuss, you know, how harsh I've been on Rahul Gandhi. I'm talking about institutional health. I am worried about the health of this institution. We have seen hundreds of sessions of Parliament, Maria, when opposition, when BJP was in opposition, they would disrupt. When Congress is in opposition, they would disrupt. I agree with you. At the same time, that is the system we have. This is what we have. We have parliamentary democracy. They are functioning. Mr. Johnson is coming here, Boris Johnson. How could his system work? And we, the world's largest democracy, it's not even about parties. It's about institutional health. It's imperative we get parliament to function in the face of any crisis. I think is the rub.
Yes, you know, Shantanu, various other democratic processes are going on. Elections have been held. Public rallies are continuing. Then why not have the parliament function? Even if the minister says that all the floor leaders were consulted, Sabha is saying rightly, call out their bluff. And call out their bluff by calling the session of parliament.
No, I'm saying I doubt this is any Tom and Jerry cartoon that we have to call anybody's bluff. So the minister is in good faith telling he called all the floor leaders. Floor leaders should tweet or they should come on media ANI that no, he has not talked to us, which I doubt is the case. I think I'll again reiterate the GST case. I'm sure I'm tracking every GST council meeting. There is not even a voting inside any GST council meeting. There's all agreed,
all
right? And they come out out and they say it's a Gobert's tax. And all the Congress finance minister and chief minister agree to it inside. I think this is the same case, right? And as if I think we are acting almost like tabliki people that corona is not there, and as if it's a false alarm, right? So when a government is acting, but I again iterate, we should develop an online model where, you know, very sophisticated, but the number is large. You talked about a lot of open air things, right? Open air things and a closed ground thing is very different. Open air election happening where in a line you can maintain distance, but this is a closed environment thing. So any closed room things is not recommended. That too in Delhi where cases are rising, that too in winter, which is a bad combination with COVID. I think this is
Let me give the final words to Sabha.
And also
these
just to add, member of parliament, member of the age category, think, member of parliament are in as largely 55, 65 plus, which is not
so
very conducive.
Yes.
Who's covered many sessions of parliament, but as I may say so, it is not about these peripheral issues. I agree. There is very poor conduct by many opposition MPs, by many attendance is an issue. Our parliament, there's so many grounds on which we can pick battles with our parliamentarians, whichever party they may be from. Maria, that's not the point. It is the system that we have. We cannot sit back and allow this session to not happen. It's an institutional thing we have to protect. Parliament needs to function. That's all. And it is functioning elsewhere and it must function in our country. That's all that I can say.
Yes, and the parliament must function even if it is in a virtual way, as a proposal has been.
Yes, exactly. You know?
Shantanu, you are in agreement as well.
I think virtual for sure. Virtual, I think this pandemic, a lot of things from schools, colleges, even Supreme Court of India has moved virtual. So parliament, if we can develop a system, I think now I have attended a Zoom call where 1 lakh people are there to show solidarity for Sushant Singh Rajput's case. I'm sure there must be ways where all parliamentarians can see, hear, language translation, all the complicity of a parliament can happen. That system should come up, if you can come quickly, at least before budget session.
Yes.
It's one of those rare occasions when Shantanu and I are sort of, there is a part of this debate on which we agree. I just keep going back to it. And the minister, I'm not doubting his words. So he needs to call the bluff of the opposition then and say that I spoke to you. And, you know, everybody needs to come out clean. And I think, Maria, as journalists, we also know We do have the right to hold all parliamentarians up. We need to pull their socks up. It's a fact. They're saying parliament, and then they don't perform when it's in session. When it's happening. So this should be the time when we consider this institution very seriously, when we respect what it achieves, what it gives us, the structures within it, and we should reiterate our commitment to Parliament and the government, which has a majority in the lower house and a near majority in the upper house, should show that commitment.
Fine enough. Thank you so much, Sabha. On that note, Sabha and Shantanu, thank you so much for joining us. That's all from me. I'll be seeing you tomorrow. Thanks so much for watching.